Here is what an inductive sensor looks like. These are produced by Datalogic and are commonly used in automated processes, but there are many shapes, sizes, and applications for inductive sensors. Most commonly, they are used as metal detectors and proximity sensors. You probably interact with a multitude of inductive sensors every time you pull up to a red light. Arrays of large-scale inductive sensors are how many traffic systems determine how many cars are waiting at a red light. That's what those strange patterns and shapes are on the road at intersections. In automation, they are regularly used to sense the presence of a metal part and send that information to a programmable logic controller. An inductive sensor is a non-contact sensor that uses a coil and an oscillator to generate a magnetic field around the sensing surface. When a metallic object enters the operating area of the sensor, there is a dampening of the oscillation amplitude, which is read by a threshold circuit and changes the output. Any object that isn't metallic won't interfere with the magnetic field that is generating around the sensing surface. The detection range of the sensor greatly depends upon the type of metal being detected. Ferrous metals like iron or steel will increase the detection range, while non-ferrous metals such as copper or aluminum will decrease it. Since inductive sensors cannot measure the distance or size of an object, they are sometimes described as an inductive switch. Their output can only be on or off. Let's take a step back. What is a switch? A switch is a device that can make and break the connection in an electric circuit. We use switches every day, from typing on a keyboard to turning on the lights in your home. There are two categories that all switches fall into: maintained or momentary. A simple light switch on the wall is a maintained switch, meaning it will remain in one state until actuated into a new one. Each actuation of the switch will change its state. The switch will maintain the on or off state that you last set it to. Maintained switches can be referred to as toggle switches. An inductive switch is a momentary switch, meaning it will only change its state while actively triggered. Once the object that triggers the switch leaves its operating area, the switch will return to its normal state. Momentary switches are sold with an output of normally open or normally closed. This refers to the default state the switch will be in when it isn't actuated. When purchasing an inductive proximity sensor, you must choose between normally open and normally closed. Think of the letters on a keyboard. Each one of them is a momentary switch, and its normal state is open. Only when that key is pressed will the state of the switch change to closed. Immediately after releasing the key, it will default back to its normal state of open. You don't have to press each letter twice to toggle it on and off. The state of the switch is changed momentarily while actuated. On top of deciding between normally open and normally closed, you must also decide between an NPN or a PNP transistor. These control the current flow within the sensor. This diagram shows a basic NPN transistor in a circuit. Currently, this is an open circuit. When we close this switch here, the current now flows from the positive terminal, through a resistor, and into the base of the transistor. The low current switches the transistor on. The same current will continue to travel through the emitter, the ground, and back to the negative terminal to complete the low current loop. Now that our transistor is switched on, we have a larger loop that becomes active. A higher current will now flow from the positive terminal into the collector. From there, it is shunted to the emitter since the transistor is now on. It travels through the ground and heads back to the negative terminal. If we were to add an output to the circuit, it would be between the positive terminal and the collector. This diagram shows the same circuit but with a PNP transistor. Although less common than NPN, they function similarly. The difference is that in a PNP circuit, current flows out of the base to turn the transistor on, compared to the NPN circuit where current flows in. That is why PNP sensors are called sourcing sensors, since they source positive power to the output, and NPN sensors are called sinking sensors, since they sink ground to the output. That makes these transistors complementary. With an NPN inductive proximity sensor, the output will be high when nothing is near it, and low when it detects a metal object near. PNP will be the exact opposite. Before picking one or the other, make sure they are compatible with your PLC you will be using them with. If you are looking for a sensor that can discover proximity, distance, position, displacement, material type, humidity, liquid levels, and more, then you may need a capacitive or a photoelectric sensor instead. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please post them in the comments and we will do our best to answer you. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to Flexible Assembly Systems for more videos like it in the future.